Some of you don't see it right now, but you have an opportunity right in front of you. An extraordinary opportunity. An opportunity of a lifetime. And once you realize that, once you realize that you're studying, you only get one shot at it. In a few years, that opportunity is going to fade away. You have a small window in your life where you have no responsibilities, no mortgage, no children, no one to support financially. You can channel all your energy, all your focus, on becoming the best person you can possibly be, with nothing holding you back. You have a phenomenal opportunity right now. You're living it, you're breathing it. So are you going to take advantage of it and completely transform your life? It's really down to you. How badly do you want to change your life? What are you willing to give up having the life that you dream of? Are you willing to give up the procrastination and the Netflix and the hitting the snooze button 5 times before you eventually get up? The first 2 to 3 hours of your day, as soon as you wake up, is incredibly important for how productive your day will be. The problem is, many students don't even have a productive morning routine. They just go through their life taking their time like they've got all the time in the world. So you have to ask yourself, are you willing to give up all of this for the life you aspire to have? Or do you just want to talk about it? And I mean, give it up forever. Because 2 or 3 or 4 weeks isn't good enough. You really start to see improvement when you are consistent. All the success I've had, it goes to the fact that I've understood the process and day in and day out of being consistent. I just keep doing the same thing over and over and over again. It will take a while. It might take a year. It might take 5 years. I don't know. But here's what we know. If you do it every day works. Some days don't. You just need to, every day, study. Have you done what you said you were going to do? Did you study when you said you were going to study? Or did you get distracted and put it off? There's always going to be a reason to procrastinate. There's always going to be a busy schedule. There's always going to be something unexpected that happens. It's always going to be that way. You have to work through it. But a lot of students don't want it enough. People who succeed stick to the plan regardless. When you tell yourself you're going to study, you need to do it. Be obsessed over your future. Be consumed by the opportunities. The super successful don't stop when they hit their targets. They simply reset and go again. This opportunity is not going to just sit here and wait for you to come and get it. You've got to chase it. Like a man possessed, you got to go and get it. And if you can find within yourself the part of you that wants more, you want to make a bigger difference, you want to push a bit more, you want your grades a bit higher, you should never be satisfied with the grades that you've got. Because the attempt to achieve more makes you into something phenomenal. A lot of students are caught halfway between improving themselves and not improving themselves. They watch motivational videos on YouTube and trick themselves into thinking they're making a difference in their lives. There are too many students just half invested in personal development and growth. There are too many students just half wanting better grades, just half committed, just half grinding. There are consequences that you pay when you're constantly seeking comfort and avoiding discomfort. Remember the last time you procrastinated so much that you didn't study for an exam? Then do you remember the disappointment you felt when you received your exam grades? And if you make that a habit, then you're never going to feel like you've accomplished anything. You're not going to have this understanding that difficulty and struggle and the ability to push through that is a muscle. And the more you push through difficult situations, the bigger that muscle grows. And it'll get to a point where you're so used to pushing through difficult situations that it just becomes a habit. And that's when you start to achieve great things. That's when you understand that it's easy to overcome obstacles. If you've never had to overcome obstacles or you give up too easily, you never really know that you can. Unless you've faced actual adversity, you don't understand how you can feel and how you can react to overcome that adversity. Because right now, you're not a hero in your own eyes. You're not someone that you respect. When you're studying because you have to. You're studying because you know there's an exam coming, but you're not respecting yourself. We all have massive respect for hero figures like in the films, where the guy always does the right thing or the guy who helps everybody out. The ultimate hero. This is the character you need to play in your own movie. This is a battle that you will fight for the rest of your life. Don't give in to the resistance. Just fight it. And every day you do so, you'll win the battle for that day. And you'll continue to fight that battle every day. And if you keep doing it, you'll start to realize that you'll rise above everyone around you. You'll start achieving things you didn't think you were capable of. In the words of Eric Thomas, there's power in consistency. There's power in doing something over and over and over again. There's power in studying over and over and over again. But your problem is you're going all out Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 10 a.m. to 12, 1 to 5. And you're starting and stopping and starting and stopping. I challenge you to fill in the gaps. I challenge you to go all out Monday to Sunday. I challenge you to go from average to good, and good to great. This 24 hours belongs to you, and whatever you do in this 24 hours will determine who you will eventually become. And that's what you need to focus on. Stop thinking about wanting to become a millionaire or buying a supercar or buying a huge mansion. You need to start focusing on what you're going to be doing in the next 24 hours that will help you get where you want to be. You have 24 hours. And in that 24-hour period, you can either break your life or make your life. Les Brown once said, "You're going to hit a wall, and that wall shocks some people. That wall discourages some people. That wall stuns some people. It's painful hitting that wall, but some people hitting that wall refuse to be denied. This person comes back anyway, again and again and again. And if you keep on hitting that wall, here's what happens to you. That you will have an incredible breakthrough." And it's as if the universe says, "Let's help him out. Come on. I admire that kind of tenacity. Let's give him a hand. This person doesn't care about the pain because this person knows something. There's no gain without pain. You can come out defeated and give up on your dreams, or you can come out with excitement and looking forward to the new opportunities in front of you. Starting the day in the morning, in the first few hours after waking up, it's absolutely essential that you start being productive immediately. If your morning is productive, it's likely the rest of your day will be too. I've just uploaded a video on my second channel, going through my morning routine, with all the productive and healthy habits I implement within the first 2 hours of waking up. You can check it out by clicking on the video on the screen. So, I'll see you over there.